from my butchers here in the meat lab, and they're going to start breaking it down. Okay, so we definitely want to know, the yield grade is really for the packer. Consumer doesn't care about the yield grade, right? Because they're going to get it trimmed anyway. The quality grade is for the consumer. The yield grade is for the packer. We got to know pretty much what we've got here. We got to know how marketable this is and whether we're going to sell this to certain lines, to certain customers. We know that we have a food service rail that we're going to push to food service. There might be retail. Different lines depending on grades, et cetera, what we're looking for.
By the way, this is an upper two-thirds choice. This average choice. So it would qualify for that upper two-thirds choice.
Right. And that's kind of what I was drawing at. This is pretty much a middle-of-the-road carcass. And just a really quick introduction. Dr. Alfredo De Costanzo is sitting all the way in the back. Raise your hand, Alfredo. Okay. He's our faculty member that runs our feedlot. This was his effort that came from Rosemount. Okay, he hit exactly what a feedlot's trying to do right now. It's a yield grade 3, top choice. Okay, if you're shooting for prime, you're not doing your job right. If you're trying to shoot for ones, you probably shouldn't be doing that either. If you're trying to hit 3 or better for yield grade, that's exactly what this did. So this is acceptable, this is what we're doing. The only thing that's rare about this carcass is I would call this an old school carcass, a 1975 style carcass, because this is a 1,200 pound animal. How heavy do you think the animals are going in the packing plants right now?
17.
No, about 1375 to 1380 on average. Okay, so this is light. She's light for going into a packing plant, but did well. Okay, we can go forward. We can cut this. It's got a slightly smaller eye. This eye is probably about a 12 square inch eye. Most of the ribeyes you're seeing on retail are like 14 square inches, so they're bigger. Yes.
Can you tell what breed that is after the hide is done?
Typically not. Typically you're not going to be able to do that. I know there are people that say they can do that, but I've not been able to see anybody do it. That's why if they're certifying Angus, they're certifying 51% black hide, there's somebody that's on the kill floor that once it's been basically spray painted and been certified outside, they see that spray paint and the hide comes off, they remark it.
Now, you can tell a difference between a dairy breed and a beef breed. Because there's a couple of characteristics you can look for. First of all, the ribeye will be more of a triangular shape, meaning up here at the top it'll be narrower. And then the other thing in the round, you know, obviously dairy-influenced cattle are lighter muscle than our typical beef animal. And so their round would also have a triangular shape, and it wouldn't be that shape of the muscling to that round. And their rib cage is huge compared to a conventional beef. Their rib cage is a lot bigger. So there's some things you can tell. And then again, the muscling would carry down into the chuck. You wouldn't see as much muscling in the front end either.